Just because you're not a code ninja doesn't mean there's nothing you can do to improve your search rankings. In fact, some of the most important SEO factors are things you can do without touching a single line of code. Let's get into it. Hello, creators. I'm Ben Tolson from Podia, where we empower creators like you to make a living doing what you love. While there are important methods for improving SEO that involve code, a lot of it is built on a solid foundation that has everything to do with your content. Ahead, I'm going to give you 9 ways you can improve your SEO, no coding required. Number 1, make the right kind of content. When someone uses search, they're often looking for a specific type of content. For example, if I'm searching for a recipe, instructional content is going to meet my needs better than a sales page. But if I'm searching for a replacement side view mirror for my 2007 Honda Odyssey, don't ask. And the deer is fine. He's fine. I'm probably looking for a sales page and not a blog article. This is part of what's called search intent, which is the ultimate goal of the searcher when they put in a query. When making content, it's important to consider what type of content a person is usually looking for when searching for keywords related to your topic. Google will typically offer up content that fits the type most people are looking for when they search. So if your content centers around DIY dog grooming, you can see that list-style how-to articles perform really well. Number 2, craft a compelling page title. Have you ever heard the phrase, "Don't judge a book by its cover"? The thing is, we do. We can't really help it, and search is no different. Before we click on a link, we make judgments about how relevant and helpful the content will be based on the title. Maybe you're wanting to avoid being clickbaity, but the title may be your first and only opportunity to convince someone to click. As long as you're not over-promising or being misleading, it's okay to use your title as an opportunity to grab people's attention and compel them to click. Here are 4 things to keep in mind when coming up with your title. Include your brand name. It's a good practice to put your brand name at the end of your title after a vertical line, as shown in this example. This is good for building brand recognition and also has been linked to improved search rankings. Keep it between 50 and 60 characters. For most results pages, 50 to 60 characters is the sweet spot to make sure your title isn't cut short. It's not as simple as a specific character count because different letters take up different amounts of line space, so you might want to test different titles to see what works. There are tools out there that'll actually give you a preview of how Google might display your title, but it's always a good idea to test it out in a real-world scenario. Point to the value. The most important question your title should answer for the searcher is, what do I get out of clicking this link? You want to make it as obvious as possible who this link is for and what value it will bring them. Appeal to emotion or instinct. People are much more likely to pay attention to something if it speaks to emotions, offers a sense of mystery, or provides a sense of structure. It's even more powerful if you can use all 3, like 7 signs you're a cat person, number 5 will make you LOL. If you've made amazing content, take your time creating an equally great title so people will actually click through. Number 3, include links to internal and external content. One of the ways search engines judge your page is by a metric called authority. A website or web page has authority when it's seen as a reliable and trustworthy source of information on a given topic. One of the ways to increase your page's authority is to link to relevant content both within your site and on other websites. When you do this, you're giving your visitor access to even more valuable information, which increases the overall value of your page. You don't have to include a link in every paragraph, but start with the goal of providing value to your visitor and look for opportunities to link them to additional resources where it makes sense. Number 4, add structure to your page content. One of the best ways to keep someone from hitting the back button on your website is by structuring your content. People feel overwhelmed when faced with a wall of text. No matter how valuable the information is, if it doesn't look easy to read at a glance, most people won't stick around. This hurts your SEO ranking for 2 reasons. 1, lower dwell time, that's the amount of time someone stays on your page after it loads, signals to search engines that the information wasn't relevant. And 2, it's harder for search algorithms to make sense of unstructured information to determine whether or not your content matches a searcher's query. Use these 5 techniques to structure your content. 1, use titles to break up major sections. 2, break your text up into 2 to 3 sentence paragraphs. 3, bold or italicize key phrases or words. 4, use bullets or numbered lists. And 5, use block quotes for valuable takeaways. After you've added some structure, reload your page and do a quick scroll through. Does it look visually interesting at a glance? Could someone skim through and understand what your web page is about? If yes, you're good to go. Number 5, include keywords and phrases in your content, but don't spam. If you want to rank for specific keywords or phrases, it's a good idea to use those keywords and phrases in your copy. When a search engine crawls your page and finds your keywords or phrases used throughout the content, it's more likely to rank your page for those keywords and phrases. But much like I'm doing, repeating the words keywords and phrases throughout this section, spamming or overusing your keywords and phrases, that's too much, can be seen as trying to game the system, and it's also not a great reading experience for your visitor. Look for opportunities to use them, but don't overdo it. It's also a good idea to use related keywords in your content. LSI keywords, or latent semantic indexing keywords, are words related to your main topic that help the search engine gain a deeper understanding of what your content is about. For example, if you made content about running, examples of LSI keywords could include shoes, shorts, gels, distance, or marathon, just to name a few. If you're writing about a subtopic related to your main topic, try to go another level deeper. Like if you're writing about running shoes, you might include related keywords like a specific brand name or words that describe shoes like comfortable or durable. Number 6, add images and video. When it comes to your page's authority, having a variety of different types of content makes a big difference. Google tends to promote pages with images and videos above pages with only text because it understands that different people prefer to consume content through different mediums. And while it's great for your brand to produce your own images and videos, you don't have to make it yourself in order to benefit. Even embedding external images or videos can help your page's search rankings. Videos also increase dwell time on your page, which signals to search engines that your content is relevant to searchers. Pages with longer dwell times tend to be ranked higher. When using images, it's important to keep a couple of things in mind. 1, don't use images without permission. It may seem convenient to do a quick Google search and use an image that fits well with your content, but if you use an image that's protected under copyright, you could be subject to a fine. 2, be sure to optimize your images. Many of the images on Unsplash are full resolution photos, which means at full size, they can be up to twice the size of a 27-inch computer monitor. Even if your webpage displays the image smaller than that, it'll still take longer to load, which negatively affects your SEO ranking. If you search for Image Optimizer, you'll see several free tools you can use to optimize your images. JPEG-optimizer.com lets you compress and resize your photos. In most cases, I recommend setting the compression between 60 to 70 and resizing the image width to no larger than 1200 pixels. A final tip for videos and images. It may seem obvious, but the more relevant your images and videos are to your page content, the more they're going to help your search ranking. Number 7, produce quality content. It's probably no surprise that the higher the quality of the content, the better it's going to rank. But what are we talking about when we say quality? Here are some questions you can ask. Does it deliver on its promise? This is probably the most important question. The primary job of the search engine is to satisfy a searcher's query by providing the most relevant and accurate results. The more satisfying the information, the better that page is going to rank. If the title of your page hints at solving a problem, answering a question, or providing entertainment, make sure your content delivers. Does it contain spelling or grammatical errors? Believe it or not, having misspellings, poor grammar, or misused or missing punctuation can hurt your search rankings. It can also hurt your brand perception and make you seem unprofessional. It's always a good idea to double check your content, or even better, get another pair of eyes to help you find and correct any mistakes. Is it easy to consume? Easy to consume content meets the following criteria. It's well formatted. As I said earlier about avoiding a wall of text, well formatted information is just easier and more pleasant to consume. It's not bogged down with ads or unrelated information. If you have a full page pop-up ad that appears moments after your page loads, it's more likely that your visitor is going to hit that back button, never to return again. The page loads and displays as intended. It's important to be aware of any display issues on your site, even if you yourself cannot fix them. Maybe your content looks great on desktop, but it's really difficult to read on a mobile device. Check your site on multiple devices so you know whether or not it needs tweaking. The content is easy to read and understand. If you've got an amazing vocabulary, like Shakespeare level, it's tempting to want to flex those lexical muscles. Lexical, relating to the words or vocabulary of a language. Maybe that'll earn you some points at the dictionary club, but your search ranking is going to suffer. You want to avoid speaking over your reader's head, but you also want to avoid insulting their intelligence. Most SEO companies recommend writing content at a 6th to 8th grade reading level. Books like To Kill a Mockingbird, The Hobbit, and the Harry Potter series fall within that range. It also helps to imagine you're just having a real conversation with somebody. How you speak to someone in real life is a great way to keep your content from seeming too formal. Number 8, make your content longer, or maybe shorter. There's an ongoing debate in the SEO world about whether shorter content or longer content performs better. The question they're really trying to ask is, what length of content are searchers most satisfied with? The answer is, it depends on what they're looking for. A good way to answer this question is to do a search for the keyword you'd like to rank for, and then look at the word counts of the top ranking pages. This can be a good guideline, but above all, you want to make sure your content satisfies the searcher's query. Maybe a page with fewer words is ranking well, but that's just because they haven't been able to read your amazing content yet. Number 9, make more content. One way to give every page and article on your website a boost is just to make more. The more content you have related to the main topic of your website, the more authority search engines will give your website as a whole. A rising tide lifts all boats. If you're consistently producing relevant, helpful content around your topic, every page will benefit. And that's it. Hopefully you found these tips helpful, but if you only remember one thing, don't be a Shakespeare. Just kidding. Remember that you're writing for people, not search engines. Making content that's truly helpful goes a long way toward increasing your authority and visibility. Did any of these tips surprise you? Which of these tips will you use for your content? Let me know in the comments. If you found this video helpful and you want more content like this, be sure to subscribe and hit the notification bell so you don't miss any of our future videos. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.